Hey, scientists, it's Kanisha again. Check out my new fish tank. I'm so excited to decorate the bottom of my tank. But there's just one problem. These toys won't stay down. It's like there's a force that keeps pushing them back up. Do you think the force underwater works a little differently than the other forces we've learned about so far? I think it might. Let's investigate the force of water and figure out why some things come up and other things come down. Last time we saw each other, we learned how gravity is the force that pulls things down, but water actually works against gravity to push some things back up. Watch as I toss this coin into the water. When it moves to the bottom of the tank, it's sinking or being pulled to the ground. That's gravity. Now, I'm going to put this sponge in the water. The sponge doesn't sink. It moves to the top of the water. It's floating. That's strange. This sponge is a lot bigger than the coin. Maybe floating and sinking aren't always about how big something is, but about what it's made of. Water and gravity fight against each other when it comes to floating and sinking, kind of like a game of tug of war. This coin is heavier than the sponge. It's tiny, but it's really hard. The metal is tightly packed together, or dense. The water's force isn't strong enough to push it back up. Gravity wins, and the coin sinks. What about this rock? Do you think a rock would float or sink? Rocks usually sink. They're dense and heavy too. Glass and metal, like this anchor, are heavy materials that usually sink too. Do you notice anything different about the sponge's material? The sponge is lighter than the coin. It's squishy and has holes in it. It's no match for the water's force. It floats to the top quickly. Objects that are light, fluffy, or let lots of air inside of them usually float. Let's observe a few floating things and investigate why they float. Plastic and rubber toys, like beach balls, are full of air, which makes it easy for water to push them up. Pieces of wood, like twigs and sticks, and even logs, float too. You know how easy it can be to snap a twig? That's because wood isn't dense, so the water can push it up. Leaves are light and flat, like feathers. Remember how feathers resist gravity and float more slowly to the ground? This shape helps objects float in the water, too. I have one more question about floating and sinking. Sometimes boats are made of heavy materials, like metal, but boats usually float, right? What do you think it is about boats that help them float? I think it's their shape. Boats are thin, flat, and hollow. That means they're open on the inside, leaving space for air. That spread-out shape helps the water push even heavy things to the top of the water, so we can carry lots of things or people across the ocean. Now that we know a little bit more about floating and sinking, let's choose some toys that will sink in my fish tank. I have a rubber duck, a metal anchor, a wooden raft, and a glass castle. Can you choose two that will sink? Circle the toys that will sink in your science sketchbook, and we'll experiment with each toy when you're ready. The duck and the raft are floating. They're both light. Plus, the duck holds air, and the raft is flat. And the anchor and the castle are heavy and dense. They sink. Thanks for helping me find out what floats and what sinks today, scientist. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey, hey.